Good afternoon. You're watching Nine News Now. I'm Amber Sherlock. We begin in Sydney, where an investigation has been launched following the death of a violent patient inside an emergency department. Tiffany Genders is following the incident, which has renewed calls to improve hospital safety.
The 33-year-old man admitted himself to Prince of Wales Hospital here in Randwick last night to be treated for mental health issues. It's understood he lost control and became aggressive in the emergency department waiting room, where security guards and paramedics stepped in to try to restrain him. Nine News has been told the guards were bitten several times during the struggle. Police backup arrived with officers placing the man in handcuffs on a stretcher. It was then he went into cardiac arrest and died. This tragic incident has again thrown two major issues into the spotlight: our mental health system and the safety of staff in patients in New South Wales hospitals.
We've been calling for at least 250 extra health security staff, health trained staff, people who understand drug and alcohol abuse, people understand mental health. Last night, we would like to see probably at least two more people on. Clearly, what we had was not enough.
Our staff are important to us. Their safety is critical to us in the health system. And of course, patient safety is absolutely critical.
The man's state of mind and his history will be looked at as part of the critical incident investigation.
There's been a major breakthrough in a Queensland cold case, with 80-year-old Vincent O'Dempsey charged with a 1964 murder of his associate, Vincent Allen. Allen's body has never been found, but a coroner previously ruled his death likely occurred in the Warwick area. Last month, a $250,000 reward was offered for information on Allen's death. Now to Melbourne, where reporter Sam Cucciara has the latest on the men responsible for capturing alleged murderer Jonathan Dick, who's faced court today.
One of the men who helped bring down Jonathan Dick here in the heart of Melbourne says he did what he needed to do despite knowing the fugitive was dangerous and likely armed. Dion and his business partner David noticed the murder suspect stalking them in a city car park yesterday morning, and that's when they pounced.
Everyone's happy that he's caught. Dave, I can sleep easy now, so we're all good.
There was no choice involved, you know what I mean? This guy was never going to stop until he killed David. He was lucky that he caught him, you know? They just caught him on the side of the eye and they dragged him down.
Now, David is a former schoolmate of Jonathan Dick, and Nine News has obtained this footage of the fugitive savagely beating him with a hammer last year, all while Dick was still on the run, wanted over the shopping centre samurai sword murder of his brother.
He was a danger to the public, yeah. He was someone that we've been wanting to get into custody for quite a while, and certainly for a little period of time at least he was living in that Fitzroy area, in a sort of homeless capacity, but I guess it's a case of no one sort of recognising him when he's done that.
This morning, 41-year-old Dick faced court charged with stalking his former friend David, as well as his attempted murder. The fugitive was sporting stitches, he was well-mannered, and when asked if he was Jonathan Dick, he replied, "That's correct, Your Honour," before thanking the magistrate as he was ushered back to the cells. David and Dion say they can now sleep a little easier now. They could also share in that $100,000 reward on offer after bringing one of Australia's biggest manhunts to an end.
Cardinal George Pell will tomorrow learn his fate after appealing his 6-year prison sentence for sexually abusing two choir boys. Three Court of Appeal judges will hand down their decision, which is expected to take around 40 minutes, live stream for the world to watch. We'll have coverage of tomorrow's verdict live on Channel 9 from 9:30. To federal politics now, and some exclusive details on a bold new plan to cut power prices. Let's go straight to Jonathan Kersley in Canberra. Good afternoon, Jono. Take us through it.
Amber, the Queensland LNP is being urged to disconnect from the national electricity market. This is a push from Federal Nationals MP Keith Pitt. He's told Nine News it could cut the cost of power bills, but only for Queenslanders, and could leave other states in the dark. That's because at the moment the state often produces far more electricity than it actually needs, and it can feed power to New South Wales, to Victoria and South Australia. But there are concerns from experts within the energy sector that if Queensland was to disconnect from the grid, it could result in blackouts in New South Wales and Victoria. The Nationals MP, though, says he's driven by one motivator, and that's price for consumers.
If Queensland stands alone, that excess supply will drive down the wholesale price, which then drives down the retail price. These are Queensland assets paid for by the Queensland people, owned by the Queensland people. But we can't continue to prop up states that make silly decisions.
That, Amber, is a swipe at Victoria and the state Labor government's target of 50% of renewables by the year 2030. But not everyone agrees with Keith Pitt's proposal that it will result in prices falling. One energy economist who advises governments on energy policy has backed the proposal, but it's received bad reviews from others. Take a listen.
If the states take control over their own policy, they can get better control over pricing for consumers.
But ultimately, the generators can't withstand lower prices and lower profits. Something would probably close down and the whole thing will re-equilibrate and the prices in Queensland will go back up again.
Amber, Nine News understands the Queensland LNP leader and MPs have been lobbied to back the National MP's idea and campaign on it for the next state election. But Nine News can reveal neither are yet to say publicly whether or not they will back it.
Jonathan, thank you.
Hi YouTubers, I'm Davina Smith. Well, click here to keep watching Great Nine videos and subscribe to our channel here for lots more news, analysis and exclusive content. For breaking news, see you at 9news.com.au.